is a 50 watt hybrid amplifier, which marries a high voltage Class A tube preamp, which is based on a 12AX7, to a Class D power supply. But despite its small size and the fact that it's in a pedal, it is a full featured guitar amplifier. It's not a modeler, it's not an emulator, it's actually an amplifier. It does 50 watts into 8 ohms, or 100 watts into 4 ohms. Over the years, I've had a lot of customers that have toured, and I've toured myself, and we always just try to find something that will fit into the smallest space possible when traveling, especially traveling internationally. So with the amp here, you have a full featured 50 watt amplifier, and it'll run on any voltage anywhere in the world between 100 and 260 volts AC. So you just plug it in and go, so you don't have to rely on backline gear. And then also, if you're playing a gig and you have this and your amp goes down, you have a great backup option here. We have a really simple, easy to use, clean control format here where you have your input volume, and then bass and treble controls, and then a master volume, which kind of controls all of the different outputs. On top of that, you have a reverb control, and then two knobs for the speed and depth of the tremolo. And both of those effects can be bypassed with the foot switches. That's it in its most basic function, is this: it can be used as a guitar amplifier, but it's a lot more than that. You can use it as a preamp. It's got a pedal output, so you can just use it as a pedal, like if you want to plug your guitar straight into something where it hits a tube and then go into your pedal chain or into another like modeling amp or something. When we were designing the amp, it was really important to me to add the headphone out, so you can use it as a practice amplifier or to dial in your pedals, write songs, or do whatever you want to do without any noise coming out of anything except going directly into your head. The sound of the headphones is pretty authentic to the sound of the amplifier itself. On top of that, you can run an XLR out of it into recording software or into a mixing console if you want to go direct. There's no substitute for the interaction between the magnetic guitar pickup and the grid of a vacuum tube with high voltage on it. So that interaction is something that you're missing when you're recording often, where you're plugging directly into an interface, and this will get you there. We kept the XLR output fairly faithful to the sound of the amp itself. So you can get a really good tone very easily. There's three controls for volume, treble, and bass. You just set it, you don't have to go through any menus, you don't have to click on anything. You just plug in and find your tone, and it just sounds good right out of the box. I really wanted to design a product that was for everybody, whether you're playing every day of the year, or if you're playing at church, or if you're playing at home. I didn't want it to be an emulator, I didn't want it to be digital, I just wanted it to be extremely simple to use and something that anybody could get a good sound of, no matter who you are or what you're doing.